Hey guys, so today's video is one of my favorite things to film, and it is a monthly favorites from the month of July. We are in August, I have no nails. Life is crumbling beneath me, but we're gonna move forward. So the first favorite that I wanna talk about, I thought it was only fitting, is a foundation. This foundation is not new. I've talked about it several times on my channel. It's worth talking about again and again and again though, because it is a true favorite, and it's from Maybelline. It is the Matte and Poreless Fit Me Foundation. Mine is in the shade 220, and I think it matches me quite well. I love this foundation, and I certainly have been showing it love in the month of July, but even more than that. I know May, June, July, all of those months I was using and grabbing for this foundation. This is a really nice coverage. It's medium to full. I have pretty clear skin at the moment, but I do have hyperpigmentation. Some would even call it melasma, but I try not to call it melasma because that makes it sound worse than I want it to be. But even with those dark spots, I get the coverage that I'm looking for, which is a pretty close to full coverage. It is a matte foundation, as the name suggests, but it's not so matte to where it looks like straight powder on your skin. Don't worry, I definitely powder afterwards, so it wouldn't matter even if it did. But I do like the level of matte that this provides. It's very long wearing. I cannot think of one thing bad about this foundation besides the fact that it does not have a pump. That's really annoying, but we use it anyways. It's also from the drugstore, so it's less than $10, and I'm super happy about it. We do have a snoring puppy in the room, and as usual in my videos, I wouldn't dream of making him stop, so deal with it. Moving on to the next product, how do I apply the foundations? And it's with a brand new sponge that you guys may have heard of, but I had never tried until the past couple of months. And this is from a company called AOA Studios. They are a brand that is based, pretty sure, out of China, and they have a lot of different products to choose from, but I think they're most well known for their beauty sponges. They also have several different ones. This specifically is the Pawpaw Wonder Blender. I literally, because it's coming from China and because they're so inexpensive, I did order like 9 of these at a time, and I gave some to my sisters to try. This is the one that I just used today. Probably the softest sponge I've ever used. I will say that. Seriously, so cloud-like, so bouncy, so plush, so soft. The best thing about these though is that A, they work. Yes, love the texture. I love how they work and they apply my concealer, foundation, powders, but they are literally $1.55 each. Okay, so if you're like me and you've been throwing all caution to the wind and spending $20 on a beauty blender, please stop. Let's all stop, okay? These are so good. The only difference that I can see between this and a beauty blender is that this does seem to pick up a little bit more product or soak up a little bit more product than the traditional beauty blenders do. And that is a downside to this product, but it is not even close to being on the spectrum of something that would make me buy a beauty blender instead. This is going to be my sponge now. I'm just going to continue buying these. This has also lasted me a while. I opened this one up probably close to 2 months ago, maybe just a month ago, but still, I mean, there's no tears in it. It's still holding strong. I wash this every single day. P.S. Another thing I want to mention for washing your sponges, what I use is the cheapest, most no-fuss bar of soap ever. This is from Publix, which is a grocery store where I live, and this is the gold deodorant soap. It doesn't matter. It doesn't have to be gold. Doesn't have to be deodorant soap. It's literally just like store brand, cheap as hell, probably not great for your body, probably really drying if you used it on your actual skin. But for sponges, it's great. So if you are also a person, and I was, who was spending, I think, $16 to $18 on the Beauty Blender Solid Cleanser that works great, I will say that it works really well. Guess what? So does this. For a pack of 3, this was like $4. So buy yourself the cheapest bar of soap you can find. If you can get one free from a hotel, those work great too, and it's free. But that's what I use. I've been loving the sponge. I've been loving the soap to clean it on an everyday basis, and I think you guys should try it. Okay, something that I don't have with me, but that I have seriously, it's almost a joke that I'm not wearing them today because it has been every day. Every single day I've been wearing these is half lashes. What I mean by half lashes, if you're not familiar, is I literally take the Ardell Demi Wispy Lashes, I cut off about half to a quarter of the end of the lashes, and I just glue that onto the ends of my lashes after applying mascara. That has been my daily look. I mean, I'm so addicted to it that even when I'm just putting on a little bit of makeup, I still do that step because it makes such a difference in my look, in my opinion. I actually do, in my highlights on Instagram, have a little tutorial for using half lashes. So if you want to see exactly what I mean and exactly how I do it, go over there and check it out. My Instagram is always linked down below. It's at @nat_fabulous. It's such a nice thing because of the following. Let me get into this because I'm super passionate about it. One, it is not excessive. Today I have on a full lash and I love how they look. I think they're super like flirty, dramatic, very like glamorous. I love it. However, for an everyday work type situation, half lashes are so awesome for that type of look. So any sort of like understated, but you still wanna feel like you have some pizzazz, you have some glamour to you, use the half lashes. So I love what they do for your look, but they're very undetectable. They do not look like, oh wow, Natalie spent literally 2 hours on her makeup today wearing a full lash. It's almost undetectable to the naked or untrained eye. So adds just a little bit of flair like I was talking about. The other thing is so fast to apply half lashes. I mean, fast as hell. That's why I do it even on days when I'm wearing like just minimal makeup, just running to the store, just going out for a couple minutes. If I'm wearing minimal makeup, I still do it because it's literally like 40 seconds total. So fast, so easy as well. And that's the other thing, is it's so easy to apply. There is no worry about, well, it's gonna lift on the inner corner. Oh, it's poking me. That's the last point, is that it's so comfortable. It's fast, it's easy, it's comfortable. I never worry about them. I forget I have them on. Literally, they're that great. Whereas even though I feel like I do a good job applying a full strip lash, I can feel them and I probably will at some point be like, okay, I'm annoyed now and take them off. Half lashes are like, I could sleep in them. Like there's nothing there. So lots and lots of good reasons to try out the half lash thing. Again, check out my Instagram highlight story if you want to see me applying them in a little tutorial, but I absolutely love them and I cannot get enough. Okay, moving on, I have a product that one of you recommended to me and thank you so much. I love when you guys comment, not just for recommending products, but commenting in general. It really makes me feel like I have real life people watching me and that is a big deal, more than you would know. So the product is a brow gel. This is from NYX. This is the Control Freak Eyebrow Gel. And I do have another drugstore eyebrow gel, but I was asking in that video that she recommended this for a, like, your favorite drugstore brow gel, because I just, there's certain products that I can get behind spending a lot of money on, you know, something that I have to buy from Sephora or Ulta or something like that, like a higher end brand. I can be convinced pretty easily to spend some money on some makeup, but there's certain products that I'm just like bored with. Like, I don't want to go to Sephora every time I need a brow gel. Like, can't I just go to CVS? You know what I mean? And brow gel is something like that. It's not a fun purchase for me. So if I can just get something for cheap that gets the job done, sign me up. And that's what this is. It is completely clear. Like I said, the wand is like a traditional mascara wand. This is very close, if not an exact dupe, for the Anastasia Clear Brow Gel. I honestly can't see a difference. Now, I do not have thick, unruly, crazy brows, but I do have brow hairs that will fall down throughout the day if I don't use a brow gel, and this works. So I do suggest you try it out as well. I really, really like it. Next, I have a setting spray that I've really been liking. I'm actually like almost halfway done. I don't know if you can tell, you probably can. This is from the brand called Innisfree. This is the Dewy Glow Mist with Jeju Cherry Blossom. And I got this months ago. I think I've mentioned it on my channel before, actually, but I'm mentioning it again, so just let me. This is really nice because it isn't, number one, it isn't super expensive. Even though it's like a Sephora held brand, it's not like $35 for a setting spray. I think this was $18. No, not cheap, but still more reasonable. You get what I'm saying. This I like because it says dewy glow mist, but it's not gonna really give you, which this could be like a bad thing for some of you, this isn't gonna give you like dewy, glowy skin. Like, it's really not. I have decently oily skin. I would say like actually oily to normal. So I don't actually love like full on glow dew like on a daily basis. I really prefer not. I just wanted a setting spray that was going to rehydrate my skin and settle all of my powders into my skin after I apply 38 powders. And I do, and this is fixing the problem. The other thing that's really nice about this is the scent is nice, it's very subtle, but also the mist is very, you saw, it's very, very fine. It never spurts out. It is just really nice. I find myself using this quite a bit on a daily basis when I'm doing my makeup. I will do this before and after highlight. It makes a difference and it's really, really nice. I've been enjoying it. Two more products here and they are my favorites, okay? One I recently talked about on my Instagram stories and I saved it as a highlight as well. So if you wanna see it in action, it is my favorite highlighter. Now, this is interesting because I've had this highlighter in my collection for years. Actually, like literally almost 4 years. For the number. I have used it and loved it and appreciated it, but it also is a highlighter that is a little bit too dark for my skin when I'm pale, and a lot of the year I am pale. So therefore, because I know in my head it's a little bit darker than I can use, only I can use this when I'm tan, because I have those parameters in my head, this has kind of just got pushed back to the back of my like collection and I haven't pulled it out that much. However, this summer, having a little bit more of a tan, I have pulled it out and I cannot believe how good it is. Like, I forgot how good it is and now I realize how good it is, and holy shit, I literally ordered another color because I can't not. You guys have to try this, okay? It's not cheap, but you have to try it. Are you ready to hear what it is? Jesus Christ. It's from Illamasqua. Do you guys have anything from this brand? It's not super prevalent in the US, but it is one of their powders called the Beyond Powder, and it is in the shade Epic. So it's a highlighting powder, obviously. I am wearing it today, and I'm gonna wear a little bit more because I just want to. So, I mean, with the lights, God, I do not need any more, but, hi. This is seriously, okay, let me just explain why this is so good. First of all, the color is so nice for, like, my shade to even a little bit more tan. It is very, like, rose gold bronze. Now, I'm gonna swatch it here, and it's not gonna blow your mind the way it would if you applied it. It's just not. This swatch, if I saw somebody swatch this, I'd be like, it looks fine. No, you have to get this, you have to apply it. They do have other shades, like I mentioned. I did purchase one, and I'm waiting impatiently for it to get here. It's getting here this week. I'm sure it's gonna be in next month's favorites, because I like it that much. They do have other shades, so if you're paler than me, you can get that. If you're darker than me, or even very deep skins, you can find one to fit you. This is just such a good formula, and I have to quote my sister Morgan, because she was over and swatching things, and she was like, you know what this is? This formula is thin. And that is what I think is the ticket here, because it really is like a thin veil on your skin that looks wet, okay? It does not look powdery. And I think I'm realizing Beyond Powder might be a really good name for this, okay? But seriously, guys, I don't know what else to say. Can I just show you and then you can believe? It is a very unique, beautiful formula. I can't get enough. Where I purchased the other one was Beauty Bay. Is it taking 3 years to get here? Yes. Am I upset about it? Very. However, it was the cheapest price, even including shipping, that I could find. So you can do your own research on that. I'll link it down below so you can buy it from Beauty Bay if that's where you want to buy it like I did. It's worth waiting for. I just know it. Okay, 6 minutes on a highlighter and I still have one more product. This is different, okay? Like, I have to introduce every product in such a ridiculous way. Do you guys remember the brand Cargo Cosmetics? I mean, I barely remember it. I know that they were, and maybe still are, sold at Kohl's, which, does anybody actually shop at Kohl's? Not anything wrong with that. I just never shop at Kohl's ever. Anyways, Cargo Cosmetics, I looked it up. It still exists, and they do have a website where you can purchase this exact shade. This giant blush is what I have had in my collection. I depotted it. It did come in like a cute little tin. I depotted it and it's magnetic, so I've had it in like a little Z palette. This blush is another thing I've had for years, and I started using it this past month. I can't get enough of it. I'm wearing it today. I hope it's coming across enough. I might put some more on just so you can see. I'm gonna look crazy in person, but I want you to see. It is such a stunning summer shade. Like, oh my God. I know it looks like holy shit orange, and it is holy shit orange. Actually, the color is not holy shit orange, it's Laguna, but this looks so intimidating, so scary, especially for white people, but it's not. Like, especially if you like blush, first of all, you can do like a light layer, but if you're like me, you can also pile it on, and it brings so much life to your face. Sorry, I keep looking in the monitor like so much, but it brings so much brightness, youthfulness. It is stunning. Now, this is an all matte blush, so I do love pairing it, as always, with like a highlighter, but I just love it. I absolutely love it. Like I said, it is still available. It's a huge pan, so this will last you your entire lifetime. So I think it's worth trying out. I just love it. If you like the color, if you're looking for like a punch of summer, look no further. This is literally it. Oh my God, I almost forgot. I have one more product that I really wanted to talk about. It's what I have on my lips right now. This is so good. This is from Maybelline. This is their newer gloss line called the Lifter Gloss. This has hyaluronic acid. The shades are stunning, all of them, but I love the shade I got so much. Obviously, it's the only one I tried, but I think I did a great job choosing. Like I said, it's what I have on right now. It doesn't have super high pigmentation, which I actually prefer in a gloss. I like there to be some sheerness to it. I don't really want like a liquid lipstick shine look. I want like mostly shine and a little tint of something. They do have like sparkly shades like this one, and then they also have more like cream formulas that don't have any sparkle or shimmer, but are just like a super glossy cream. I mean, these glosses are, every single one I see, stunning, absolutely beautiful. Mine is in the shade Sand. You guys, if you follow me on Instagram, may have seen me mention this before. Let me try to get a close up. If you look at my nails, I will fight someone. But this is what it looks like. Can you see the shimmer in there? It's hard to see with the glare off the bottle. Speaking of, I love the packaging. This acrylic packaging, very reminiscent of like KKW Beauty. And I love everything about this. Let me show you also the doe foot. Really big doe foot applicator, which I think a lot of us really like right now. This shade is stunning. I want to show you though, it compared to the Fenty Gloss Balm. Because when I tell you, this formula is the closest thing I have found to the beloved Fenty Gloss Balm, I'm not joking. So I'm gonna swatch this for you. This is the Maybelline Lifter Gloss. Oh my God, so stunning. Even this shade is similar to the original Gloss Balm from Fenty. So that's it there. Super, like literally the word that comes to mind is juicy. Sorry, but it is. Not sure if you're fond of that or not, but it is high gel formula, concentrated, just like very plush, very juicy. So then I'm gonna show you, like I said, this is the Fenty Glow Gloss Balm, the first one that she ever came out with. very similar doe foot. The Maybelline one I think has a little bit more color to it, but hopefully you'll get the gist of it. So this is the Fenty one, this is the Maybelline one. I mean, probably a lot of glosses will look similar when they're swatched next to each other because what they all have is that high shine. But seriously, formula-wise, actually wearing it, you can tell, if you're familiar with this Fenty gloss, how similar it is. I would really consider it a dupe. I honestly would. I love it. See how shiny it is? Like, it is stunning. I absolutely love it. Okay, glad that I didn't forget that. And now we can continue on with the video. Okay, and after all of that, that is everything. Those are all my favorites for this past month of July. Thank you so much for watching. If you did enjoy this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Seriously, do that. Don't not do it, just do it. Also, subscribe to this channel, would really appreciate it. And as mentioned previously, I would love it if you would comment something down below. Seriously, like, I don't wanna film videos and just see the number of views. And that's not enough for me. Like, I want people, real people, a part of this channel. You guys know what I mean. So please also comment, and thank you just in general for being here. I really appreciate it. I do hope you'll stick around on my channel, and I'll see you in my next video. Okay, bye.